Gloria, we're going to welcome in a very special guest, the winner of our 34th annual 620 CKRM Big Country Talent Show. Had the big finals there in May. And Dallas Elder, welcome into the studio. Congratulations on the big win.
Well, good morning, sir. Thank you very much.
Sir, and lady over there, too, yeah.
No, I'm just going to let you two go at it and talk about this. I think you're going to talk about manscaping, aren't you?
Oh, that is right up my alley these days.
You're styling a fine stash there,
yeah,
Dallas.
Well, as Dallas usually comes into our talent show. By the way, how many years have you been in it?
Oh, three.
3 years.
Third year.
Right. You know, some have been in it. It takes a long time for some to win. Some win the first year when they come in. And so your third time in, you're the big winner there. Tell people a bit about Dallas Elder.
Well, I grew up in Cornack, Saskatchewan. I moved to Estevan. I've been working, actually we just moved to Weyburn now. I'm working in Estevan still, electrician. And I absolutely love to sing, been playing for years and years. I think we started with band Parallel 49. We started when I was 15, I think, and we played all over the place, bars, things like that, cabarets, weddings, and things have slowed down a little bit there, but doing this competition really got a kick in my butt to start getting some ideas to play again.
So your band was Parallel 49. Do you play solo now, Dallas, or do you have a group out there that you still travel with?
No, actually, we haven't played in about a year. I've been trying to focus more on work and getting through school. I start school on Monday, actually, for my third year apprenticeship. So, focusing more on that right now, hoping when I'm done that to get back into that again.
So, this will be just part-time while you get a career going, and then you can fall back
exactly,
on that
should
the music career not work out. On a full-time basis, I mean.
For sure, yeah.
Are you planning to make it full-time? Could you see this as a full-time career?
I hope so. That would be best-case scenario. I mean, that would be really nice. I've always loved to play. I've always loved to sing. Love to perform. And, yeah, absolutely, I could do that.
Yeah, because we've had people in the talent show, Gloria, like 11 years old. We've had them start at 11. They're there when they're 19. They've been with the show so long. Like, how old were you when you started singing, playing, or just realizing that this is what you want to do?
I started playing. My grandpa Marv gave me my first guitar when I was 14, maybe 15. Started playing that, and then it just kind of took off from there. I just started playing around the house, and all of a sudden I got with the band and thought maybe I could do this. So then just kind of took off from there.
Now, talent shows, I know there are a lot more in Saskatchewan than there were years ago. Seems like every town or even the casinos have their own talent shows where you can go get experience, win some money. And tell us a bit about your experience with our talent show, what you've learned from coming into our Big Country Talent Show over the years.
Well, it's so well put together. It's just an amazing event. Everybody there is just absolutely unreal. They can sing. It's a lot. It's not more. I was at Canadian Idol in 2007 and 2008. And you know, it's more of a production than it is a singing competition. And this is just pure singing competition. Everyone's amazing. It's just great to be a part of.
So we're talking to Dallas Elder, in case anybody's wondering what's going on. And you've gone through the process of getting into the recording studio. How did that turn out for you? Was that something that was basically a whole new venture for you? Or when you were with the band, had you guys dabbled in that a little bit?
No, actually, we did a little bit of basement recording.
Yeah.
But yeah, no, it was very exciting to be a part of that recording studio. I went in, I was very nervous. I had no idea what it was all about, but I got in there. It was very comfortable. It was an awesome job. The band did an amazing, amazing work on the song, and I'm so happy the way it turned out.
Okay, quickly, the musicians who were in the studio with you.
Actually, I wasn't there with the musicians. I came after it was all done, and I wish I could have been there. It was amazing.
Laid your vocal tracks down. And
exactly, yeah.
And who produced that?
Oh, Grant Hall at, what's it called? The studio name. I can't even remember it. Touchwood Studio. Sorry
Touchwood,
about that.
Yeah.
Neither could I.
Because
that shows you how we're on holidays, man. Don't worry about
but
it.
But that was part of the package. We pay for a recording package in there. We get the single and distribute it for you. Now, quickly tell us about the song.
The song is called High Lonesome. Very, very excited about how it turned out. The steel guitar. Oh, I love the steel guitar. I was very happy when he told me that was going in. It's very country. I went in and I have a few songs written of my own, but nothing country. So I went in, and he had a few songs picked out for me to listen to, and this one absolutely caught my ear. I I couldn't stop listening to it and recorded it. Turned out awesome. It's turned out I wanted more of a traditional country song, and that's exactly what it is.
All your coworkers in Estevan listening right now?
I sure hope so.
Well, good morning, everybody. Mom and Dad listening right now?
I think so.
The singing electrician.
Hey, listen, give your girlfriend a nice hello here, because she comes with you everywhere, be it the talent show or backstage at the Craven Country Jamboree. And why haven't you got a rock on that finger yet?
I'm working on it. It's my beautiful girlfriend, Shelby. She's with me everywhere I go and with me here today.
And they're a good-looking couple. Okay, the name of the song again?
Hi, Lonesome.
This is Dallas Elder, winner of our 620 CKRM Big Country Talent Show. His first of many singles, we hope, on 620 CKRM. Dallas, we'll talk to you shortly after this song. Try one more time, Dallas. You just had the mic off a little bit late there.
That was Dallas Elder on 620 CKRM.
Hi, Lonesome. I love it. Listen, Kenny Burton's playing guitar. I love the steel guitar and that. Great job, Dallas.
Absolutely love it. Thank you so much.
our winner of our 620 CKRM Big Country Talent Show.
And I think we've made you blush about four times today, Dallas.
I feel a different color right now.
Kind of got that Luke Bryan kind of look, doesn't he?
Oh, wow.
Oh, yeah. I can substitute. You'll be stunt double this summer at Craven.
Thank you. That would be nice.
It'll make you walk out into the crowd of crazy women.
We don't have to walk far out there.
Shelby. You'll be more of a bodyguard this year than ever. Well, this is really exciting. Good for you. That sounded awesome. And Jamie, you said the writer of that was
Terry McBride from McBride and the Ride. Yeah. So they wrote some very good traditional yet modern country songs, yeah. And that's what that was, kind of a bridge between the old and the new. The Steel, I just love that.
And quite a unique process, huh? One that you'll never forget, and hopefully there's lots more opportunity.
Absolutely amazing. Yeah, it made me realize how much I really did enjoy it.
Mm-hmm.
Good. Why don't you give your electrical business a plug? Do you have to go back to work today?
No, I'm probably going to go back tomorrow. Neralta Technologies in Estevan, Saskatchewan.
Good. Well, listen, Dallas Elder and your lovely... Where's that rock there? We're going to put a rock on that finger.
Jamie buys rings for every girl that comes in here that's unattached. It's just one thing he does. Funny. It's a nice service he has.
Never cost me a penny.
No.
But no, I certainly put some rocks on those fingers. But Dallas Elder is great to see again. Best of luck. We're going to play this single lots and lots, and we'll play whichever single you throw our way there. And I'm sure, like Lori said, there will be a lot more coming our way.
Thanks so much, guys. I really appreciate it. It was an amazing experience.